Another metal detecting day. What? Serious? During the intro? Wait, let me just show you this. This is awesome. Look at this guy. This Patrick is always at it. I'm during the intro. Man. Really? Was it deep?
No. This is.
Oh. Well.
Nice.
That's a good start of the day.
Yeah.
Wow, man. I don't know my Panzerfaust, but is it a 60 or the 100? What is
the big
it?
One?
This is the 100 version.
Yeah. Never found it that complete. But,
yeah.
Most of the time they are very rotten, but it's fired, so can go home.
Yeah, I'm gonna take home.
Yeah.
Oh, nice find. During the introduction. Because what I wanted to say is we're actually in the backyard of the owner of the cabin where we're staying. It's right over there. Not sure if I'm pointing the camera right, but no, he gave us permission to search his property. So well, that's a good start. See you at the next find then. First find is a bullet casing. I think it's German. Not really sure, let me try to zoom in. Well, I can't tell what it says, but I see a 17 and is it a 36? 38? Oh, an S5. Hmm. Oh, P. Yeah, this is German. German casing. And we were wondering who manned the trenches, and so must have been the Germans. By the way, before I forget again, I forgot in the last video. After the last video, after the time capsule video, I was contacted by a guy named Paul. And Paul he pointed out that I was using very, very rubbish gloves, not protective enough. And he works for a company that sells them, and he provided me with these. It's really, very good gloves. He sent me more than just these. He sent me several types, but these are guide gloves. These are the 650, and they're amazingly good gloves. Really am. Really are. They are really thin and protective and good gloves. Go get them, guys. Guide gloves. Thanks, Paul. Thanks a lot, Paul. Appreciate it. On this hole here, besides this little tree, which I really tried to spare, came this, which looks very interesting because of the ring on top. It's very light, so I don't think it's a pocket watch. But I'm just gonna brush it off and show you guys again. Ooh, very curious. It's not silver, it's not. Very light, sort of aluminium or something. Oh, let me just try to clean it a bit, show you guys. No, it's not gonna clean up. Let me just brush it off. Give me a sec. Well, I cleaned it up a bit. And as you can see, this is the back. And this is the front. And I think it was a compass. Cool. I was just cleaning out my bag. Because we are gonna move to another area and found some bullets. Which I can't bring with me, but I'm gonna bury it right there or something. But I also wanted to throw away some stuff buried with the bullets, and I discovered this in my bag, and I just pulled off a little cloth and those two swords appeared. Some sort of badge, but it looks a bit modern, and I've never seen a badge like this before, but I'm gonna ask Patrick, he'll probably know. But yeah, cool. I wanted to throw that away. Patrick just found a little toolbox. And it's devastated, but this one is nice. And they're all just little iron thingies. But he says it's a toolbox, so it probably is. This guy knows his World War II relic stuff. And he left again, and so I have to put it back in the hole, I guess. He does it every time. Hey Mike, I got something for your film. Yeah, right. And then he walks away. So thanks again, Patrick. But nice find. Nice find to show you guys. Patrick runs away again, and you know when he runs away, we want to show you a find for the video, and this is it. Came from this hole right here, and he took right off again. So it's me who fills up the hole. But he found a nice big casing, and there is some writing. Let me just try and film it for you. Well, it's a bit hard to see, but oh no, it's not hard to see. It's a 45. And let me see if there's writing here. Nope. But cool big casing. You wanted to leave it here, so I'll take it. Nice. Oh boy. Oh boy. This is good. This is very good. And this was one thing that was still on my wish list. And I must admit, it's very poor condition, but still, it's a very, very cool find. Let me just show you guys. It came from the hole over here, and I had a signal like this, and I was hoping for a gun. And well, it is, but it's very, very brittle, and time had its way on it. First I thought it was just a tree trunk, but then this came out. Now, if you can see it, I first thought, oh well, it's just a piece of crap. And then I saw this, which had this glass thingy, and then this came out of the hole. And as you can see, I think it's a sniper rifle. Oh, this is mad. Look, the glasses are intact. Of course, this, and you can see part of the trigger right here. Wow, this is great. I know it's in crappy condition, it is, but wow, what a great find! Great find. Awesome, I'm really happy with this, really am. It's you, Paul, with those guide gloves. It is. They bring luck too. Thanks, buddy. Another ooh. Let me show you. Let me just zoom in a bit. It looks like another gun. You got the back right here, and the barrel runs all the way through here. And I'm gonna dig it out some more and show you guys. Ooh, it's gun day today! This is it. A bit clean up. Ooh, it's gun day today. Next is gonna be a Luger. Nice! I have no clue what it is, but you guys know and tell me. I don't know my skulls. Come on, tell me. Just leave a comment, okay? Is it a deer? It's not a boar, I know that's for sure. No, probably a deer. It has some really good teeth. Cool. Something decorated, and I'm not sure what it is, probably of a watch, but I think it's a pretty modern watch, maybe from the DDR time period, looking at the design here. I just found this, and at first I thought it was a cigarette case, but it's not, it has this bluish stuff inside which feels like paper. Let me just lift it. Let me just first put my detector down. There we go. And I think there was at one point a lid on the other side too as well, but didn't find it yet. Let's just try and open it and see what's inside. Well, I have no clue at all what it is. No idea. Let me know what your thoughts are, okay? Thank you. Good thing Paul sent me these gloves, these guide gloves, because this stuff is all over the place. Here, and this was just sticking out on the ground, and there's a signal somewhere down here. And it's a high signal, an aluminum signal, so I'm just gonna leave it here. It's probably a bottle top. Or is it? No, okay, I'll just leave it here. I don't want to dig in glass. Oh, Patrick just found this. Very cool. This is what we're here for, guys. Cool stuff. Well done, Patrick. I don't know much about car mechanics, but I know what this is. Not a clue what it is in English, but a piston? Well, you know what I mean. You know what it is. It's from a car and it goes like that. But nice find. What did you find, Patrick?
Looks like a binoculars.
A binoculars, yeah. Probably is. You think it's German, right?
Yeah.
Okay. Very cool.
Compass on it, on the front.
On the compass?
Little compass.
Oh, yeah. Oh, didn't even see that. Nice. Zoom. Nice. Too bad it's pretty busted. Very cool find. You usually walk off now. At least leave me to it. Don't worry, it's an animal bone, a cow bone, or somebody buried his very large wife here. But it's been someone tried to saw it through and see. So this is probably a cow bone. Pretty heavy. Just found a little surface find, which looked like it's pretty new, pretty modern. And someone's been digging over there, and the find was just right next to it. But if you see the top, let me just try and zoom in. Zoom. Oh. Yeah, there it is. This is pretty old. I think it's actually World War II. Never found them in this condition before. I'm gonna do some research and let you know, but I think this is World War II. This looks like what we call bakelit, pre-plastic, before the time plastic was invented. Yeah, I'm happy with that. We're just having a beer at a local digger, a friend of ours. Me and excavator Eric are coming many years here, and as you can hear in the background, he's having excavator Eric having a beer with them. And it's always fun, and these local diggers always tend to brag about what they find. They find much better stuff than us, of course. And let me first show you these vines, which I think is pretty cool. These are the rims for, I think it was an Opel vehicle. Very cool. There's an, even an, a logo on there. Just on one. And according to my friend, it's four different rims. And he found them in one hole, so that's pretty strange. After the war, they must have threw them in one big hole. He also found these, which are the, well, what's it called? Beroepsband for a tank. He thinks it's an armored vehicle. And there's also some stamps on there, as you can see. I'm sorry, the lighting is pretty dark here. It's pretty it's getting dark soon. And what's its most wonderful find this year, except for all these shell casings, there's a big stack of them. What's the best thing he thinks is really this, a drop container. It's complete, and it was dropped with gasoline. Gasoline was poured in here, and it was dropped to supply the units. So this is a very cool find. It was like a meter deep. Already having one beer or two, and I started to get a bit tipsy here, I think. But it's just a very cool find. It's very big. Just for perspective, what a find. Would love to find one of those. Don't know how I should get it out of here in my car, but still, would be great. And the back is over here, and he has another one over here. These things were dropped down with parachutes to supply the units, of course. But that was it for this video. Hope you enjoyed it. Please give it a thumbs up and subscribe if you already didn't. See you next time. Eric is doing the dishes, but he's not doing them well. Bye.